Itachi. Damn it. Alright. I need it mostly. Happy Sunday, y'all. How you doing? Nah, I'm not gonna make it too fast. It's okay if I'm a little bit late. Fashionably late. Good morning. Happy Sunday, y'all. Dude, I'm just gonna put up some fresh links of some songs and stuff, dude. My phone broke. It ended up finally breaking. So, that's cool. It's all good. I'm just not having a phone. It's like being away and being the brains. I'm usually not on my phone. I only use it for music or communication with my family. We have that always inside of us, you know, to just shut up and listen. You know what I'm saying? But I'm getting a new one today, so it's all good. You guys probably don't care about that. Things I'm gonna work on for myself is gonna be to stop cussing so much. Make it easier to cuss a little bit. You know me, I'm a Marine, so it's a good way to get some stuff out, you know. Sometimes it just comes out. Maybe it's the French in me, you know. I mean, I'm of age anyways, but I know I got kids and stuff, and I don't want them to repeat it and all that, you know, especially in school, so I apologize, I'm working on it. Yeah, that was really crazy with the whole, my phone, like, it broke, like, when I was, before I even went to work, too, like, it happened during my workout, so I was like, damn, so I was like, especially, you know how it is with real life. When you just get a job, man, and everything's going so good, and you need the phone for all that, man. Right, and then it fucking breaks on my. But they're understanding, of course, and all that good stuff, too. Thank God. I think we got a spare phone somewhere. I gotta fucking link it up. Let's do like a swap thing. Ain't that crazy as soon as I make a video? Dude, it's the luck. What the fuck? All good. Everything else is going good. That's my problem, man. I don't know why I'm saying that right now. I shouldn't be like that. I should know better as a Marine. Maybe I'm getting kind of soft. Nah, I'm just kidding. I'm not. It's important for. It's important. You know, that's another thing. It's important to. That's one thing that. Here you go. It's good for military people getting out of the Marines or what, or just athletes. Adapting. It's good for adapting. You know, so I'm used to always doing, being that hardcore Marine as an NCO too, a corporal to E5 sergeant. I'm used to always being that backbone, you know, of the USMC going so hard and being that. I mean, I'm already kind of a, I'm a badass, but I'm a sweetheart. Like, I'm cute as fuck though. I'm not good. Like, I am even, I can't be mean. I cannot be mean. Like, I can't. I don't have it in me. Like, I can't really be around sin violent people or mean, evil people. I can smell it on them, and I just can't. And if I'd have to be, like, let's say I'm in the same kitchen or I'm in the same atmosphere as them, you know, because we coexist, I'm not going to just, like, you know, walk away because I got to get my shit done. Then I'll just, me and my wife too, my angels, will just have to sit there and take it. And, like, water comes out of her eyes, like tears, like, don't waste my tear, like a mermaid's tear, a merman. But it's not bad, it just means it's a good thing, you know. When you don't have watery eyes and whatnot, that's a bad thing. When you have watery eyes like me and whatnot, just saying, that's a good thing. It means you're healthy. It means you have clear eyesight. Like, you know, that's why people put eye drops in their eyes and stuff. I naturally have that, so that's good. Not trying to toot my own horn or anything. But that's part of the whole patience is a virtue thing, and just understanding and loving people. And when people do say mean, once again, mean and evil, insulting things, or lies, it's so easy to just say anything, you know, or evil stuff about anything. It just goes in one ear, not the other. You continue on, you move on. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me, you know. You know, like John Candy, I'm full dark. What you see is what you get. My wife loves me. My son loves me. My family loves me. My angels love me. Jesus Christ loves me. You know what I'm saying? It's not a problem. Like, it's on them, you know? It's on them. And I say, it's like you are digging your own hole. You're damaging your own heart when you're mean and evil. Your own vessel, the beautiful body that God gives you. You're damaging all of that. It makes it even worse when you're drinking and doing drugs as well. Because your body's even... It might not even remember it or will down the line. And... there's really not coming back from a lot of the shit that you people, or some people do. And you gotta live with it forever. And you curse you and yours for eternity. And that's on you guys, man. I mean, I try to tell you all the time. It's like, you guys are fucking mean. And then you're hypocritical, and you have the audacity to judge and point the finger at other people, and then you look and there's four pointing back. Like the song. You know? When you can point a finger, but there's four pointing back. Is anybody there? It's a song. It's called "Is Anybody Out There?" Beautiful, gorgeous song. And the thing with adapting is very important, because like I said, going on to the regular civilian life, you got to learn to deal with that kind of stuff as a Marine as well, or a military man, or anywhere you go. If you're in the freaking, if you're a monk, if you're in the ministry, you know, you learn and you adapt. And it's easy as not touching or hurting anybody, and then moving on from there, and then just going wherever God leads you to go in your body and your soul. And if you're Jacob, like me, Israel, and David, Sammy D, you're automatically going to be blessed and anointed. We're automatically handsome and darker and smart, etc. Because we're blessed like that. We're a loco. You know, it's not all love. Could be a prince. So we're automatically blessed like this. So it's just taking that, and sometimes, like I said, most of the time, the best thing to do is do, like my father said, do nothing at all. Go for a walk, do Tai Chi. I'm going to do a Tai Chi session before I go to church. If I make it, if not, I'm going to go later. I want to do Bible studies with Brianda anyways, and Louise, and our wives. They probably go to work later on after I get their new phone. But anyways, probably get a good nice meal in it too. But it's as easy as that. Forgiveness is divine. And that's when I literally will just say, I forgive you. Just leave me alone. It's not on me anyways, it's on the Father, so I appreciate it, but at the end of the day, it's on torture, it's on him. Our Father, the Almighty Yahweh Shai. Cat. There's nothing but love with me, man. You know me. Look at me. I'm a fly. I'm glad I found this. And adapting is important for me too, because it would just also for everyone. It just has to do with picture it, and what's a good way to put it? Losing yourself, breaking yourself up, and you gotta adapt to waiting, we're in the waiting process, and you do that by literally maybe sometimes just sitting here waiting, which that's my wife. I'm not a waiter. I am not a fucking waiter. I am a doer. I will fucking get up. I'll be like, fuck this. I'm getting the fuck up, and I'm gonna go fucking do it. It's fucking Sunday. I don't care what day it is. I'm gonna fucking do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, cool. Fucking give me that. You know what I'm saying? I get shit done. I don't fucking wait. For the man went out of the Father's house to be joint with his wife and brought her back here, and that's what I did and continue to do. Eve, angels, boom. For the son left back when I was 18, 19. And we have children together. It's beautiful. 144 kingdom father, kingdom husband right here, baby. You know why? Because I'm a fucking doer. And we're in love. It's more than that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and shout out to everybody who... Hopefully you find yours, man. Hopefully you find yours. If you don't, then fucking leave them alone. But that's for someone else to deal with. Like, I don't know. Like... Look at me. You know, can you tell I'm a good father and good husband? I'm just trying to... Even kids who aren't mine, I'm trying to save. Even people who aren't part of my tribe, 12 tribes of Israel, I'm trying to help. I'm trying to save. I love. You know? I don't care if you're Edomite, Sodomite, if you're poopy fart, or I'm there for you. I love you. And I will try to understand. I really will. I'm not you, though. I'm not you. You're not me. But I'll accept you. And as simple as that. And I'll keep your mouth shut, too, guys. Don't say anything fucking mean. I don't know why I gotta keep saying, keep your mouth shut. If you ain't got nothing nice to say, then shut up. And the shit you say, like I said, it affects you, the vessel doing it. And it is a total expansion of what you think about yourself. And you're just saying it to someone else just because they're simply there. You know? That's like me thinking, oh man, I'm an ugly, fat leper. You know? And then someone's upstairs who's like a beautiful, handsome, like, Chinese guy. And I just go up to him and I'm like, hey, you're an ugly, fat leper. And he's just like, now he'll be like, wow. But the only reason why I said that is because I think that about myself. You know what I'm saying? That's just an example of something, of shit I witness, and it's true. So, like I said, pray for your enemies, pray for those who persecute you. People are evil in this world, as you can tell. Those Esau and Cain seeds, they never change. That's one thing. Tupac had nailed that on the head, and that part of it. Some things will never change. Some things will never change. Some. Only some. There's always room for that faith of a mustard seed, and that's what I have faith in, and I believe in miracles. And I believe in the God, and I follow, and am married to the wise miracle God, Jehovah Jireh, you know, the God of Isaac, Abraham, and Jacob, me, Israel. David, can you see it? Come on, baby. You know? And it doesn't care. He loves you. You know? And me and my wife love him so much. If it wasn't for him, then we wouldn't be here. You know? Or we would have never fucking had our son and our daughters. You know, my son turns 5. It's May. Oh, happy May 1st, by the way, guys. The pool will be open soon. Great summer. Blessings and miracles coming. You already know. Starting with that new phone today. And that's going to be another thing. It's going to be cool to go to church in about 15 minutes or whatever I go, or in a couple hours or so, whenever. It'll be cool to sit in church and not have that phone on me. It's like back in the day, back at SJF. You know, we would go to church every Thursday. Remember that in middle school? And we wouldn't have phones or whatnot. If we did, of course, they would take it. Or, you know, it's going to be really nice for me. Just not having that phone. I never pull out my phone to church anyways, usually. Unless it's something important, but it's going to be really nice and beautiful just not having that even, you know, on me. So that's a start of adapting and then going on from there. Of course, I need it anyways because it's the 21st century, and like I said, that's good what I'm saying. But, you know, yeah. Well, that's a point of adapting. also similar to just a Marine or someone in battle, or just training, active duty training, or reserve training. Just being out of those uniform services and not doing that training even once a month, and just simple as coming back to a regular civilian life, whether it be on disability, whether it be getting money from the GISI, or whether it be going to college or working in a civilian way, that is a huge, huge, huge jump. And sometimes it takes years to, or sometimes never, in a good way, to get back to, you know, because it's always inside you, in a good way. That's what they train you to do. United States Marine Corps, I got the, you know, and in a good way, that's what the training is for. Just like in the movie Rocky, you know, he trains him to not only be the best he can in the ring, or, you know, for, in the case of the Marines, you know, for your certain job or just being a Marine, honor, courage, commitment, but also outside of it, where Marines outside forever and ever, super fidelis, always faithful. We're the strongest warriors, baby, inside and out. The espiritu of the core, espiritu santos, it's inside of us. It's love, it's God, it's family, it's our wives, it's our children, and it's America, and it's Jesus. And it starts with the USMC. It started in 1775, a year before the Declaration of Independence in 1776. It started in Dunn Tavern in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. 1775, a year before, so even before America became a freaking, you know, official country, the Marines were, got there first, you know, kind of like Flash, you know, fast. So, to the adapting thing, sometimes the adapting thing is just as simple as, not actually being there, like, you're not in the training anymore, you're, you know what I'm saying, you're, but you're always going to have that inside of you in a good way. And you know, that's why they teach us all that, you know, McMap and et cetera. And it's more knowledge than anything. Don't you remember all the knowledge? Of course we do. It's more knowledge than anything else. People are always like, oh, he's a Marine. Or like the movies, you know, they always depict us in some type of way. Or like PTSD or bullshit like that. That's all bullshit. We get more knowledge in church than anything. And love and brotherhood and sisterhood. All those beautiful women and gorgeous, strong women out there. It's an honor. That lives forever. So sometimes you don't even need to. It's not even about adapting. It's just about us growing. We're all growing. And it's beautiful. So Semper Fidelis, once again, always faithful to everyone. Inside and out of the Marines. Yeah. I felt good. So I'm glad I did all that so early and graduated college and what I'm doing now. I'm such a huge demographic and beautiful demographic, I can help. And please, vice versa. As a big family, honor Beaver House. It makes it worth getting up this early. It makes it worth everything. It makes it worth tears. It makes it worth, because we're all in this together. We all need somebody to lean on. You know what I'm saying? That's a beautiful Good Sunday talk, it says. No alcohol involved or any of that drugs or anything, just us, you know? So, we'll do a little Tai Chi sesh and we'll end it on that. Yeah. I really like that. Just, growing, adapting, and understanding. That's a great way to label this. Say I love you to my wife, my son, my wives, my angels. You know who you are. I love this one girl. Beam Your Light. She's beautiful. She's another like 144 beautiful woman, like wife, or you know, just kingdom woman. And I really, for girls or guys or whoever who watches this, I'm a guy, and I you know, it's good to watch both. So especially so I can, you know, have some insight on the other side too, and get some empathy, understanding of, you know, kingdom woman. But her name's like Beam Your Light, and there's also like Stephanie Smith, and there's That's not a good one. Oh, Shantia. Oh, it's beautiful. I call them like wives of mine, seriously. Like buddies, just angels. Angels. And I recommend them for any kingdom woman or soon to be kingdom bride or wife you may be, or soon to be kingdom mother or already one. Definitely recommend them. So nothing but positive and good vibes. It's like the female versions of me. Nothing but positive and beautiful good vibes. Beautiful dark skin like myself, woman. Beautiful gorgeous tan woman, dark eyes and dark hair. I love it. I love it. I love Jacob. I love Israel. I love us. I love us. We're the most attractive people ever. Are we? They are gorgeous. But the best thing about it is their knowledge and their wisdom, their oil, their skin, their soul. Definitely. As people of God. Hebrew Israelites, you want to call us? I call it 144, baby. We're angels. We're gods and goddesses. And our light of God and blood and whatnot, etc., shines more so in the out than the in. Or, I mean, more so in the in than the out. We're beautiful inside and out, guys. Like Riley from the one movie Inside and Out. I have a daughter named Riley, but yeah, a daughter named Riley. What? Her name is Little Ray. All day, DGK. I know, but I can also put new songs on my phone when I get it. For my workouts and whatnot, and for my singing and stuff, and serenading to my beautiful romantic wife, because that never stops with us. I love you. For shizzle. Alright, so what else is going on with me? Let's see. It's funny when I do that. And also, I'm sitting here, don't be ever be too hard on yourself. Like, something also I did in this video, I realized before, I'm realizing it as I go. You see that wisdom that God gives you when you're sovereign and you're sober and you're a person of God and etc., etc., He will just give you these gifts as you go, which is a reason why I do these entrepreneurs, personal training, motivational, inspirational, friendly, and sarcastic videos as well. Because as I'm going it, I can learn and better myself. So I'm learning right here, right now, that I'm way too hard on myself. Because this whole adapting and growing thing, I mean, yeah, it's cool, but this is for other people. Like, I don't want to, like, say it and have it, because it doesn't resonate with myself. So that's another great gift that God gives me, my throat. Like, yesterday, He was, like, kind of, like, poking my throat. He's like, use that sweet, beautiful voice, Sammy. They love it. The ladies love it. Everyone loves it. Thank you, because sometimes I think they don't. But no, it's the opposite. You save people, Samuel. You save people just with that voice. So I'm using it right now. So what I say is for you guys, it has nothing to do with me. Just remember that. I'm a professor, a coach, I'm a personal trainer. So just for myself to say, I can't let it resonate with me because I'm not you, you know what I'm saying? That's for to help other people. I'm like a therapist or a doctor, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't have what you have, but I'm here to help. That's exactly what I am. That's exactly what it is. It's just a... Yeah, and like I said, you already know I got the accolades for it. I went over my certifications and I even showed it to you. There's different ways to see it and all that, of my personal training certificate and diploma and all that good stuff. First aid, LCPR, all that good stuff. So that, but we'll say it again, because that's always good too. So don't be too hard on yourself. Don't take things too seriously. If there's nothing to change, let it resonate for real quick, and there's nothing to change. For me, when I was just a little bit in the beginning of the video, I was like, some things I want to work on. Nothing. What? Getting a new phone? That's nothing. There's nothing that God already said. I'm perfect in His eyes, in her eyes. There's nothing to work on. I don't even need to go to church, but I just want to. I like it. You know, it's where me and my wife are married and all that good stuff. And my son had his baptism. And I had my confirmation. You know, it's our middle school. We graduated there. And it's our parish. It's right down the street. It's where I It's where I got into the gateway of getting to my full-time job now. Through that, I don't work there personally, but I got there to where I'm at now through there. You know what I'm saying? Like a door. That's how Jesus works. Hey, I need an amen on that one, y'all. Amen. So, that goes to anybody watching this too. If there's nothing to work on, don't beat yourself up. Don't try to dig in and be like, oh, writing stuff down or thinking. If you don't think of anything, just be like, what? I'm pretty healthy. I'm pretty good. I'm good to go. That's how I feel about me too. Like, really nothing. Fulfilled. Fulfillment. So, growth, understanding yourself, oneself, and feeling, complete in God's eyes, with God, or, yeah. Loving oneself, well, yeah, obviously. Teamwork makes a dream work. gosh. Chicken Alfredo. Are you ready for this Tai Chi sesh, guys? You can tell I'm fucked. I need a little bit of something. You guys need it too, huh? You need it, you want it. It feels good. Okay. Alright, ready? Snap. Oh. Psalms 51:10. I already did it earlier. Jump the gun, guys. I love you. I did a 3 Bible opens with my friend Stephanie earlier when she was talking to me. I was with her. And it was Psalms 51:10. And it resonated with exactly what she was saying. It was, don't let your heart, don't change. God will keep you safe and sovereign and love and light and hard and warm inside. Like, stay warm, Ben David. Inside your heart forever. It was something like that. Psalms 51, verse 10. Beautiful. Nice and short and sweet. And put that up to the main Bible. Psalms 51, 10. God will keep you warm. God will keep you loved. God will keep you covered. Like a blanket. Don't change. Don't get mean. Don't. I think it's pretty obvious that I would never change, just thank God, my wife, etc. And God's got you no matter what. That was pretty much the gist of it. Psalms 51:10. I really like that one. It's short and sweet. It's for the Holy One, God of Israel, so he'll keep you warm and loved and protected, etc., etc. Session begin. Sip of water. Make sure you hydrate or whatever you need to. Especially with this pollen and all this stuff, man. On your breathing and your
gorgeous sun, so orange is my automatic color. Like the Lion King, like orange and black, the African scene, like no, actually, let's do that. Let's go to Africa. We're in the safari. Pride Rock. And we see all of us together just waking up in beautiful warm, warm colors of orange, pink, purple. Mm. Stresses or anything stupid, small stuff to worry about is gone with the wind, bullseye. This Sunday, don't set any goals right now. Leave all that for later. God will let you know. It's relaxation and understanding and more Tai Chi. Loving and knowing thyself as God loves you, no matter what. I love you. Gorgeous wife, my beautiful, handsome, strong, faithful son, turns 5, my daughters, my little sisters, my older sister, my brothers, my parents, my dog, and my whole family, and myself, and of course Jesus Christ, Lord Almighty, and all my friends, everyone, and nature, Mother Earth, beautiful, music, God, water, the small things. Thankful for our 2 eyes, our hairs, our hands, our 2 legs, our 2 arms, our belly buttons, our feet, everything that God gives us. And ultimately, I'm so thankful for the beautiful soul that God has given me and my beautiful soul mates and wives. Thank you so much, my Lord. We're sorry for about the small stuff, and we're always here, and please forgive us for anything, and we're always going to better ourselves no matter what, especially me as a 28-year-old man, mature father, mature husband, et cetera. Thank you for helping me with the felon situation, myself, and everything else, Lord. I'm in this early as I gotta get ready for church. So much. I'll continue this in church. Let's continue it throughout. That's the point of this Tai Chi meditation. You get to the point where you can just do it for... Well, God will lead you. God will lead you. God will lead you. Thank you, Lord. Continue to use me and our vessels. Like, beam your light to beautiful us as we are but vessels. Beautiful souls and eyes. Love you. Be a loca for me, Virgil. Alright. I already woke up pretty energetic, so I'm already pretty fulfilled, as you can tell, but I give this to all of you. I hope you all continue doing this as I, myself, gotta get ready for church. Of course, baby daddy Sammy D gonna be a little bit late, like always. Stay fresh. Son, Holy Spirit, amen. I love you all. Even the smallest guy, even the one, the ugly duckling who thinks you aren't loved, the little blah blah black sheep, or whoever you are, whatever color, you're especially loved. Always remember that. You always got me, you always got Jesus, you always got God, you always got us. We're all family. Ohana means family, no one is left behind.
sorry I had to have to end this kind of early, but I really do want to make it to the church. I need to be and I need to see. I need to do as a kingdom father and kingdom husband. I'm sure you will understand. What a word. Understanding. I love you. Understand that, bitch. So, see ya. Draw the attention.